anxiety and stress during corona waves. On behalf of PSPA, I would like to welcome you all to this lovely evening's webinar. I would first like to welcome our speaker for the day, Professor Dr. Ravish BN, Professor and Head, Department of Psychiatry, Mysore Medical College and Research Institute, Mysore. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
I would like to welcome the Honorary President of PSPA, Shri Ashok Pandeji, who's been leading PSPA right from the beginning. We welcome you to the webinar, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Savita.
I welcome the President of PSPA, Shri Rajendra Prasad Ji, who's been the cause for PSPA's presence today. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
I welcome all the office bearers of PSPA, the members, invitees, participants of today's program, and all the technicians who've been supporting us in conducting this webinar. Welcome all of you. For those of you who do not know about PSPA, let me take a couple of minutes and quickly introduce PSPA. Private School Principals Association is the largest national community of private school principals, which is a vibrant platform for school leaders across India. PSPA helps principals connect, collaborate, and co-create a sustainable knowledge society. PSPA offers a plethora of services, including trainings, conferences, webinars, academic guidance, legal assistance, and much more, with the intention of promulgating high standards of professional and ethical behavior in school leaders. PSPA is definitely a blessing for all principals like us who can network and feel safe in the company of the learned. Today's webinar is one such offering from PSPA. I'm sure all of us will reap rich dividends for the time we invest this evening. I would now request Ms. Eileen to play the shloka as we all close our eyes and invoke the grace of the divine. All of you, please keep your eyes closed. Thank you, Miraj sir. Though we were not able to hear the prayer, I'm sure all of us had our own prayers and invoked the blessings of God. I'm sure the divine is here with us. Thank you for that. I would now like to introduce the person who's been at the helm of affairs here. We've heard that good leaders take people where they want to go. Great leaders take people where they don't necessarily want to go, but ought to go. Yes, I'm referring to Shri Ashok Pandeji, the Honorary President of PSPA, who's been guiding us right from the inception. Sir, may I request the pleasure of listening to your opening remarks for the day. Miraj sir, could you kindly unmute Mr. Ashok Pandey
Yeah, good evening. Thank you, Mr. Mirage. Today you are very particular about muting and unmuting. I think your last time's experience has taught you big lessons. So Dr. Savita, thank you very much for this kind introduction. And I'm very happy that PSPA has taken this responsibility of bringing principals together on this platform. And in one of our last conversations, I said PSPA, its technical meaning, Dr. Ravish, is Private Schools Principals Association. But its actual meaning is, principals, please come and see the power of alliance, that how much we can accomplish together. And that is what this platform is. And this is the second webinar we have. And today your presence, Dr. Ravish, is going to give us a lot of emotional strength. We will know from your firsthand experience. Of course, we have our own experiences, but coming from you, I think it is going to first make us experience the realities, second, how to deal with it, and third, how to build resilience and hope around this huge problem that all of us are in. So this is the day for us to listen to the expert. Thank you very much, Dr. Savita, for this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. The poem Road Not Taken by Robert Frost reminds me of the qualities of our president, Sri Rajendra Prasad. Most of us felt the need for a platform like PSPA, but none of us acted. It was Sir who conceived the idea, and not just that, he went on knocking doors and convincing all of us. I know how much he worked to put all the frogs together and make this happen. We take a lot of pride in introducing Sri Rajendra Prasad as the founder president of the Principals Association. Sir, may I request you to address the gathering for about a minute, please?
Thank you, madam. My greatest success was convincing Ashok Pandey sir only. A very great evening to all the audience of this very specific session of handling the grief, the stress, and the anxiety in the corona waves we have been going through. And rightly, as mentioned by Savita madam, that we are in need of this kind of session for all the educators. We are very grateful to Dr. Ravi sir for accepting this. And PSP, as mentioned by Savita madam, is a registered society in Hyderabad as the Private School Principals Association of India. To my knowledge, and many of you may be knowing, there are many associations across the country, but confining to certain areas. But Pan India, exclusively for the private school principals, we thought of this and we discussed with the like-minded people and they have accepted. It is a teamwork. Idea may be given by, but it is nurtured, nourished, and supported by all the like-minded people. And PSP is growing as one of the largest and most respectable association across the country, predominantly on focused areas like the professional standards, the holistic leadership of the school leaders, and standing up as the single voice for the principals across the country. Let us join together and lead together for better school education. Thank you very much, Savita madam.
Thank you, sir. I deem it a great honor to be introducing the speaker for this evening. I've seen doctors, I've seen psychiatrists, I've seen lawyers, but I've rarely seen all three rolled into one. Yes, we have the most versatile speaker in Professor Dr. Ravish BN, who's our speaker for this evening. I must tell you, when I heard him during one of the trainings which I attended for COVID Santhwan, that is, he volunteered to train all of us to render a helping hand to people who are undergoing stress. I felt how I wish we principals could get trained under him, because we speak to thousands of students and parents, and the anxiety that we carry gets passed on to the people or the stakeholders of schools. So when we requested him, he was so magnanimous to immediately say yes to this. So thank you, sir, for accepting our request. And I am really honored to be reading your profile, which is rather long, but very interesting. Sir has an MBBS degree. He has medicine MBBS, then MD in psychiatry, MSc in forensic and legal psychology, LLB, LLM, MBA in hospital administration, PhD from Netherlands, and a number of post-graduation diplomas to his credit. Sir is now serving as the professor and head Department of Psychiatry, Mysore Medical College and Research Institute, Mysore. Sir has previously served as the director, Dharwad Institute of Medical Health and Neurosciences, Dharwad. He has bagged a number of awards due to his merit. He has bagged the first Asian member of European Violence and Psychiatry Research Group. He's been the youngest and most qualified director of a medical institution, Government of Karnataka. He has received the Service Award by State Government Employees Association, Young Scientist Award in the 8th World Congress of Biological Psychiatry in Austria, special scholarship from the International Society for Brain and Behavior, Greece, and then he has the Young Fellowship from Venezuela and many more to follow. Not just these, he has also been into publication. He has published 72 national and international journals. He has authored 4 chapters in international psychiatry textbooks and 3 books in Kannada. He has made more than 300 presentations and has also been awarded as the distinguished young teacher, you know, from the Karnataka state branch. Not just these, he's been the member of numerous organizations and societies where he is reaching people. And sir has won the heart of so many students and public of Mysore. We are very honored to be having him as a Mysorean. And one small thing I would like to tell about Ravi sir is, more than all these things that I introduced, he's a proud Indian. He's one person who celebrates the citizenhood of India. You can see that badge he's wearing. He always wears that, and we mostly do that on Independence Day and Republic Day. But sir is one person who gives us the pride. No, when we look at him, we see the reverence in him. Thank you, sir, for inspiring and motivating so many of us alike. We are eagerly waiting to listen to your words of wisdom, and I'm sure we are all going to go back home enriched. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Savita. I only enjoyed the last bit, that being the proud Indian. I would like to share the slide first. I think I closed it after the test run.
That's okay, sir. You can take time and turn it.
Are the slides visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, a very good evening to all of you. Namaskar, vanakkam. How should I start? Mere pyare deshvasiyo, bhaiyo aur in bhaiyon ka behno. Okay. I don't know how many really followed it. Anyway, I'm very grateful to PSPA for giving me this opportunity. It's my social commitment and responsibility to share the information. I don't say it as a knowledge, because it's all there now in your fingertips. So I really liked your slogan, better leaders and better schools. Well, in fact, if I can correlate that with my profession, it should be better doctors with better medical schools. So there is not much of a difference. I too am a teacher in a medical school, but not a principal like you. So I always start with this disclaimer that true words are not always pretty and pretty words are not always true, because now we live in such a sensitive society that any word uttered can be misunderstood. So at times, if I use any such kind of a word, it's only to convey the meaning and understanding. I do not mean to hurt anybody's feeling or sentiments. If it happens, kindly apologize. I apologize for that. Well, you're all teachers. I thought, let me start with some of these quote that how the technology has taken over the human brains. So today's children, okay, they ask their dad, no mobile phones, internet, computers, Google, what did you use in your schools? I think this is something basically we have to teach, not just in schools, in every walk of life. Okay. So you all know that before Christ and then after Christ, that is AD. So likewise, nowadays it has become before Corona and after Corona. So before Corona, there's some problem. Okay. Yeah. So I want all of you to just settle down, make things lighter, because we are all alive and kicking. So be thankful. As school teachers, you have very disciplined way started with the prayer. Remember, there was a time when schools would happen physically, and this is how our mothers would send their children to the school. The first one is how a foreign mother sends his child to the school, and then the Indian mother. Just for it. So it would be such a hectic job for the mother to send children to school. But nowadays, I think children should be saying, "Mams are better than moms." So this is an online class.
Wait for 5 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
What happened? Sir, I have to propose Sanjana Ravishankar right now.
Bada santosha.
Sanjana, are you listening? Sanjana?
Yeah.
Maybe I can't afford you to give you the whole world. You truly deserve it, babe. I hope you will truly understand when I give you the best that I can afford. Welcome to my world, darling. Please accept my proposal.
What's happening,
sir?
Okay. So, as you all are teachers, you know how the online class happened just now. Okay, this is after Corona. Now, you don't just worry about Corona. Corona will go, honestly. And India has got a very good response rate. But I'm really scared. After 1.5 years of schools being closed, what is the mindset of the children? I really pity the teacher who had to say, Nikhil, Nitin, I understand you also. Okay. Can you imagine someone in an online class trying to propose? Imagine when you were in your school days, what consequences things would have happened, not only in the school, even at home. I'm sure all of us would have got not just some whacking, quite a lot of whacking. Maybe some amount of dismissal from the school. I hope you're understanding the teacher's difficulties. Okay, you have to be so much diplomatic. So he is a doctor. He has to balance quite a lot of things. Now, this COVID has pushed the health. I mean, it's called as an industry now. With a heavy heart, I'm telling it's called as an industry because we come under Consumer Protection Act. Of course, even the schools, it's become something like that. I do not mean anything otherwise. So the COVID has exposed a lot of things. And unfortunately, many, many in the administration and in the public, they're all focused about the physical health. They don't understand there is something beyond what you see, okay? Mental health has got a huge impact over your health. In fact, your mind, neurological system, and endocrines, because you, I believe that you're all probably, when you say school, it's pre-university or before that. So that's the age when the immunity is still developing. And as you all can see, people with good immunity have recovered from COVID and they have walked back to their home. What is that difference? Okay, someone getting into complications, someone becoming, succumbing to the pandemic. It's only the difference of the hormones and the immunity level. Quite often, the psychological symptoms are neglected, okay, or ignored. When more than 50% of COVID patients suffer from one or other psychological problem. Not only just COVID patients, I mean, the whole public nowadays are facing some kind of psychological problems. So mental health is very important. One, for the primary prevention, preventing someone getting infected. And second thing is, if you are infected, not getting into complications and coming back, okay? So that's the reason you have to focus about your mental health. Now, how COVID will affect our mental health? Let me be very honest. We do not yet know exactly how much impact, okay, the infection has caused on the mental health, the direct and indirect. Indirect, many have lost jobs, many have lost earning, okay? There are a lot of economical problems faced. These are all indirect problems. The direct problem is getting quarantined, getting isolated, okay? Or being admitted, and then you have to pay a lot of huge bill to the hospitals, okay? Now the current ongoing lockdown, okay? Or feeling anxious that you might contract this virus, okay, or your family will get affected with this. So in one way or the other, it has affected across all age group, across all gender and geographical presentation. And I'm sure with the second wave, we would have heard someone near to us as a friend or as a relative, okay, we have lost them and we have suffered this bereavement. What's more dreadful is, what does this infection do to the brain? Okay, there are reports that people who are elderly are becoming demented. Okay, so we don't know, not just the lungs or the cardiac problem, but does it cause neurological problem? So because there are very many patients who have given advanced directive or will that their body can be utilized for postmortem. Okay, so mainly to understand and come out with a lot of treatment management plans. I don't want to get into too many technical terms. So let me explain what mental health is, because we are always curious to know the adversity. Okay, we always ignore the positive point of it. So what is mental health exactly? See, mental health, three components. Number one, see, health is a standard. Okay, you set a standard, and well-being is the process. It's the path that you take to reach a healthy state. So it's a state of well-being in which the individual will realize the abilities and the weaknesses. Okay, so everyone has got some ability. Okay, you would have learned in your Bachelor of Education or okay in Masters that every child has got some special ability. So understanding your strength and weaknesses, by that you can cope with the stresses of life so that you can work productively. What is that productivity which benefits or contributes to the society? Okay, so there are three components: understanding the strength and weaknesses, trying to tackle the stresses of life so that you can be productive and contributing to the society. So if you understand this, imagine how many of Indians are really mentally healthy. How many of them are really contributing? We all want freebies. I don't want to say they need, because everybody expects. Okay. But let me tell you, anything earned without your sweat will never remain yours. So mental health is not just related to mind. It's related to your emotions, the way you think, cognitive process, and also social well-being. So please understand, the way you interact with your surrounding, whether living or non-living beings, okay, makes you mentally healthy. Understand the damage we have done to the nature, and nature was giving free oxygen, and today we have to pay so much. Okay, I don't want to go into such kind of politically motivated things. So mental health means what we think, feel, and act. So it mainly determines how we handle stress, relate to others, and make choices. Our problems are related to making choices. Decision making is something which either pushes us into problem or gets into problem solving strategies. See, I don't want to scare you with first wave, second wave, third wave, or fourth wave. Please understand this. See, the red wave is something COVID related. This COVID related, see, anything which goes high, it has to come down. So you will definitely see that after some period, this pandemic is going to end. Okay, and pandemics are not new to this world. Probably last century, we had Spanish flu. You would have heard about that. But of recent times, we had this H1N1, okay, and then SARS, okay, chikungunya, dengue, okay, all these things. So once the infection weans off, there are a lot of mental health needs that will persist. And today we are going to discuss about those things. I still made a platform before going into the proper matter of today's topic. Are you all with me? Okay, thank you. Yes. See, let me tell you, we all have spent most of our days struggling to secure our life. Secure our life for what? For happiness, okay? For feeling of that safety. So we always thought that materialistic things will give us safety. And most of the time, okay, in this critical period, these comforts, these material things didn't help us. I just want to, slightly lessen your tensed feelings that children, okay, if they are left alone outside the gadgets with the nature, they can enjoy. And we have to, as adults, we have to just stimulate our childhood. I know you would be missing your students, but at least wake up your child within you. Now, let me first come to the word stress, because in the modern day, stress has become part and parcel of life. If anybody thinks that I want to lead a stress-free life, that's definitely not healthy. Okay. Life has to face challenges, and the meaning of life is how you handle these challenges. All our great epics, okay, Ramayana, Mahabharata, whatever it is, they all have taught us how to handle stress. So stress means troubled or threatened by life. Please understand this. Even if someone wants to just sit, okay, you have this famous Sprite ad, okay, Sprite pizza, okay? So it doesn't happen like that. Life always puts challenges, and you have your coping strategies. When there is a demand and when you can't cope, then it becomes a stress. Please understand. So how you stimulate your coping strategies, it always depends on your personality. So what is stressful to one person may not be stressful to the other person. Say, for example, for a medical student, okay, particularly in private medical colleges, okay, exam to har 6 mahine aate rehta hai, okay, when parents pay the money fee, why do you want to bother? Okay, if that is the attitude of one student, okay, the other student will be so scared that he can't afford to fail, isn't it? So you would have experienced variety of students with variety of stress in their life, okay? And most of the time, as a example, what I showed in the online class, okay? If the student gets distracted, okay, it becomes stressful both to the student and to the teacher. There are many multiple reasons. Okay. In fact, no school itself is a stress nowadays. Okay. Particularly in the second wave. And I don't know when so many experts, okay, epidemiologists are predicting that the third wave is going to affect the children, which is not true. Please don't get scared. Okay. There are scientific reasons behind that. Maybe I can handle that when we have question and answers, if it is permitted. So definitely how you don't have limited work and then feeling stressful, the children are also feeling stressful. Nowadays, both parents, working parents, both of them are at home. They are working from home. Okay, there is a lot of family violence. I don't mean by physical violence, okay? Verbal abuse and, okay, some kind of domestic violence. And then we have seen a lot of illnesses. And finally, uncertainty of the future. Okay, nobody knows how long this pandemic lasts. Okay, so all these things have caused some amount of stress. Now, what are the symptoms of stress? Okay, see, there are physical symptoms, there are emotional symptoms, there are cognitive symptoms. Okay, so these are all physical symptoms, right from headache, pain, shoulder and neck pain, and most of the time they will go and get investigated. They will get an x-ray done, they will get a sometimes CT scan done, okay, but no problem with the musculoskeletal system. Or low back ache, okay, 80% of low back pain is psychological, I'm telling you, okay. So 80% of the back pain, likewise the neck pain. And if you are, particularly if you are a woman and more than 45 years postmenopausal, people will say spondylitis. Okay. See, all these kind of things are related to stress. Okay. So tachycardia, your heart beating fast, not feeling hungry. Okay. Some kind of heaviness on the chest, tightness of muscle, all these are related to stress. Okay. So as I was telling, though, if those were the physical symptoms, there are cognitive symptoms. Okay. Unable to focus, concentrate, easily irritable. Okay. Fidgeting, restlessness, sleeping difficulty, feeling guilty, worry, cry. Okay. All these are some of the symptoms of stress. It doesn't mean that everyone should have all these symptoms. Okay. There can be limited symptoms. There can be no physical symptoms, only psychological symptoms. It all depends on the way they have been brought up, how they relate, and then their personality traits. So I will just show you, okay, what an anxiety and depression mean. If the stress doesn't get tackled, okay, if it persists, if there is a chronicity of this stress, it will lead to a kind of a diagnosis of either anxiety disorder or depressive disorder. So as I was showing, okay, you can see the physical symptoms of anxiety, tightening of chest, shortness of breath, tachycardia, okay, tremors, shaking. All these are similar to what I showed in the earlier slide. And emotional symptoms, okay, intense fear, okay, fidgeting. So excessive worry, okay, worry that something bad might happen, okay. So that fear of doom. Okay. So if that is anxiety, depression, okay, depression, mostly lethargy, sleep problems, okay, appetite changes, melancholy, okay. So not every emotion will become anxiety or depression. We all are human beings, okay. We should have all sorts of emotions. Only when the emotions persist, okay, beyond its relevance, okay, if someone has to make a diagnosis of depressive disorder, a minimum of 2 weeks, okay, the person should be suffering with these kind of illnesses. I mean, these kind of symptoms. So qualitative and quantitative. If there is a change in both, then it becomes a psychological disorder. So not only qualitative and quantitative change in the symptoms, but it should interfere in their day-to-day activities. Then it becomes a diagnosis. So are you all clear? Okay, these are basic information. Okay. Now coming to grief. So see, grief means it's not that somebody should always die and then you get into that grief. Even if there is a loss of job, okay, that's a grief. If you lose a pet, okay, that is also a grief. So what happens in grief? It's all transitory. Okay, usually it lasts for 2 months. Suppose if it persists beyond 2 months, then it becomes depressive disorder or depression. There are quite a number of similarities. Okay. So having body malaise, sleep disturbance, change in appetite, or because of change in appetite, weight loss. Okay. Usually, if someone is grieving, okay, they are highly irritable. They get angry quite easily. Sadness. Okay, difficulty in accepting. One of the common psychological defense mechanism is denial. Okay, we don't want to accept the reality first. Okay, and most of the time they will have dreams, or they will be seeing or hearing related to the loss they have undergone. Whereas depression, you all know, okay, that feeling of helpless, hopeless, worthless, okay, which will lead to suicidal ideation. We have seen quite a lot of suicides happening during this pandemic period. Okay, if suppose one of the spouse, okay, died because of this, okay, the other one also ending their life by committing suicide. Kubler-Ross, okay, she defined different stages of grief, and what needs to be done is been written below that. Okay, so the first and foremost is denial. Okay, doesn't accept that they have lost. Okay, just yesterday I spoke to the person. Just yesterday he messaged me. Today is not there. Okay, so such kind of denial. Okay, a shock, a intense fear. So repeated information and communication. That's why our ancient people, our in our culture, there were those process, okay, of conducting certain rituals and then making, communicating the death or communicating the loss was there. Now, as the denial starts subsiding, there is a lot of frustration, irritability, and anxiety that they have lost. Okay, then there will be bargaining. I should have if someone delayed before getting doctor's help, I should have insisted them to go before, okay, or the doctor himself feeling that I should have, okay, treated before, I should have treated with this. So such kind of a lot of bargaining will happen. Okay, that guilt feeling. Okay, now because of that, because of the loss, and if the person is the chief bread earner of the family, it will definitely devastate the lives of the dependents. So it can lead to depression, helplessness, okay? And flight. Flight means sometimes they also tend to commit suicide. Finally, it takes 2 months, okay, nearly 6 to 8 weeks before accepting and then exploring the options of how to move on with the life, carry on with the life. So if you understand when there is bargaining, and then when suppose they are dipping down into depression, a lot of emotional support has to be given. And one wrong thing we Indians do is we give free advice. See, majority of the communication happens by non-physical communication. Okay, please understand. So only by your, you know, patting the back, telling that you are there, okay, during the difficult time, such kind of reassurances will be much more emotionally supportive, rather than telling, okay, everybody has to die someday, okay, it all happens, so don't cry. Please don't try to put words, okay, for the silence. Don't tend to compensate the silence with the words, okay? And if those words are not comforting, okay, the emotion in your tone also matters. So finally, when someone has accepted and tried to move on, that is the period when you have to show some direction, because they don't have to catch a wrong path. Okay, you have all seen our movies showing okay, following the death of the parent or somebody, how the child picks up a wrong path. So proper guidance and direction needs to happen following this grief. Okay. How to beat this? How to beat stress? How to beat anxiety? How to beat depression? Or how to beat all these psychological disturbances is be active. Do what you like. Of course, when I say do what you like, not illegal activities or unethical practices. Do something which makes you feel happy. Okay. Because whenever you sweat, the happy hormones tend to get released from your body. I want to just show a small clipping from World Health Organization. I don't know how many of you really followed the process. It started with a buzz, it started with a noise, and then there was some clarity. And finally, when the birds were chirping, okay, you felt so light. So I will just play it once again. It's just 40 seconds. Slow and deep breaths. Engaging your different senses, sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch. See, this is a very simple activity. Whenever you are stressful, okay, I would like to tell you 4 D's, 4D technique. First one is delay your emotions. As people say, don't react. Not everything is worth of reacting. Okay, you can say, hold on. Okay. Second thing is distract. Okay, you can distract either in different activity or, okay, distract, okay, by just closing your eyes or just counting numbers, whatever. I'm just giving you examples. You don't have to do the same thing. Something which you are comfortable and happy to do. So delay, distract. Third thing is deep breathing. Take a deep breath, okay? Keep it for a few seconds, then leave. Do it for 5 to 6 minutes. I mean, yeah, 5 to 6 minutes. At least 10 to 12 times. And once you hold it for 10 seconds at least. This is called, in the Sukhasana, okay? Sukha Pranayama. Okay, Sukha Pranayama, usually. So once you take a deep breath and release, okay, you feel definitely comfortable, because imagine whenever there is an anxiety or a stress, what does your heart do? It tends to pound. Okay. So if you control the heart, that has a feedback over your nervous system and mind, it will calm down. So deep breathing, that is the third D. Fourth one is drink water. Okay. Even what we suggest to the patient is, okay, those who are suffering from COVID-19, plenty of water, at least 5 liters of water. So when you drink water, it definitely calms down. Okay. So these 4D techniques will immediately help you to control your anxiety or stress or anger. Okay. What are these? All of you have been listening. Loving, wise, attentive, committed, persistent, responsible, calm, caring, protective, courageous. What are these qualities? What are these called? Yeah.
Positive qualities.
Okay. No, these are called as values. Values. Okay. See, quite often, whenever we are disturbed, we tend to forget our values. And there's a difference between monetary value and the real social and psychological value. Okay. That's why whenever you have a problem, you tend to remember your parents, remember your spouse, or remember your brother, okay, or remember your friend, okay, or a senior supervisor, or whatever it is. So these kind of social security gives you so much of value. Okay. And unfortunately, today, what we have? We have 5,000 friends in FB. Okay, but who is going to help you? None. Okay, because everybody has become selfish. I'm telling you honestly. It's not my job. It's not my job. So these are the core Indian values that today we are seeing getting degraded and demolished. Okay, so this is something our students need to have. Okay. Probably we all had moral science classes, but today it's not there in the syllabus because it's not productive in a corporate world. That's why I apologized in the beginning. Okay. I don't mean to anybody. I mean it to the whole society as a common factor. Okay. These are all, okay, who will take the responsibility? Everybody wants their right, okay? But nobody wants to do any duty, because even in our constitution, as per Article 51A, there are constitutional duties, but they are not same as that of constitutional right. Constitutional right is a mandate. Constitutional duty is a preferred one, okay? So we have to be protective, we have to be caring and courageous. Okay. So all these values somewhere we need to inculcate and spread across our known and dear ones. Of course, now the education is focused on quantity, how much marks you score, but how much talent the child has. Okay. How many did predict that schools will be closed for 1.5 years? Okay. So there are many things. Okay. This I've taken from WHO poster. Okay. So engaging in hobbies other than gadgets. Okay. Please understand the difference between technology, science, and spiritual science. Technology is a better way of doing things, but that need not be protective of the society or protective of the nature. Okay, we had very big mobile phones which became smart, which became thin. Okay, does it mean beneficial? No, the radiations have become more and more. So please understand, technology and science are two different things. Ultimately, did all this technology help you during pandemic? No. Did all the developed countries come up with a very robust treatment? No, they didn't. See what our forefathers followed. Shuchitva, Swasthacharya, Dinacharya, okay, cleanliness, hygiene. Okay, we were wearing our chappals all inside our home, including our kitchen. Okay. So I don't mean anything wrong by using the technology, but we can't forget the basics. That's what I meant. See, there is no big technological knowledge needed to overcome this COVID. Clean your hands quite often. All you need is a good soap. Okay. In this third world war, okay, this is a biological war, okay. I don't want to go to the intricacies of the politics behind it. You don't need AK-57, I mean AK-56 or all sorts of things. All you need is just a good soap. When you cough or sneeze, please do like that, okay? Avoid touching your eyes, nose and mouth, okay? Often you have to wear mask. We have to avoid social gatherings, okay? Please understand, being assertive, okay, saying no is not a simple word. It's a sentence. It has got a lot of meaning in it. And we have to isolate someone who is sick within the house. Imagine father, mother having a small child of 2 years, both become COVID positive. I have seen, during this COVID period, the Epidemiology Act. Okay. So under that, all MBBS doctors, okay, we become all MBBS doctors and we have to do COVID duty, irrespective of our specialty. So every one of us would be anxious that whether we will get COVID, and then whenever we come back, there are many a times doctors would do 2 or 3 weeks of duty continuously so that they don't come back home and then they come back and get quarantined for a week and then get back to the work. So such kind of activities are going on. Okay. So please take care. Staying at home is quite essential. Cleaning the objects. Okay. Either sanitizer or cleaning with something related to alcohol content. Okay. So that will be beneficial. Now, how to be mentally healthy? Okay. Because insomnia is one of the common complaints those who are at home. Okay. That doesn't mean they are really suffering from any illness. So you have to have rest, okay? You can't keep working from home and then keep working late nights, okay? Sleep well, regular physical activity, prioritize your day-to-day activity, prioritize it, okay? Keep it as similar as possible, even if you are working from home, okay? Don't have late night meetings, okay? Because you have to work during the daytime, and then please maintain the same calendar of events and avoid junk food. You all would have told your students, okay? It's better if you teach your children, teach your students, encourage your students to cook, help their parents, okay, cutting the vegetable, all sorts of things, because it definitely becomes handy. And eat fresh cooked food, no contamination, okay? So eat healthy food, lot of fruits, vegetables, milk, okay? And then cereals. Deep breathing, mindfulness, meditation, I mean, it's an option. You can do what you are comfortable, but only thing is, it should be consistent. You can't just do for a few days and then forget it. Stay connected, because we are socially well connected now. We have, 4G, and then I don't know, 5G has not come, but video chatting. So whenever you feel like just talking, you call, okay? But of course, not disturbing anybody. See, outdoor breaks means you can go around your house, or if there is a park, okay, you can go in a limited period, maintain physical distancing, okay? And when you are doing physical activity, meaning exercise, then you ideally you shouldn't be wearing a mask, okay? But that doesn't mean it will intoxicate. Carbon dioxide intoxication will happen. But usually what happens is it will have a difficulty to your breathing. So take a little bit of outdoor breaks. You can just sit on the terrace and then see them. There are a lot of birds which are now freely moving. I think my friend from Delhi had sent, it has the lowest air pollution, okay, recorded over decades, because no traffic. So I just want to play one little bit of sentimental video clip.
मेरा पापा देश चलाता है, नहीं है नेता, लेकिन देश को वो चलाता है। वो डॉक्टर भी नहीं है, लेकिन वो मंगाता है। मेरा पापा देश चलाता है, वो पुलिस में भी नहीं है, लेकिन देश की गंदगी मिटाता है। वो आर्मी में भी नहीं है, लेकिन गंदे शेतों से जंग लड़कर आता है। मेरा बाबा देश चलाता है। अगर नहीं जाएगा मेरा बाबा काम पर, तो रुक जाएगा इंडिया का हर घर। ना बनेगा खाना, ना होगा नहाना। सड़कों पे मच जाएगी भगदड़। बच्चे स्कूल नहीं पहुंचेंगे, ना ही डॉक्टर अस्पताल। मंत्री मंत्रालय नहीं पहुंचेंगे, और पूरे देश का हाल हो जाएगा बेहाल। हम सबकी जिंदगी को आसान बनाता है। मेरा बाबा वो काम करता है जो देश का कोई भी बाबा करना नहीं चाहता। मेरा बाबा देश चलाता है। क्योंकि देश अपना गीला और सूखा कचरा अलग नहीं करता। मेरा बाबा कचरा, गटर और बीमारियों के अंदर जाता है और बहुत बीमार होकर निकलता है। कभी कभी लगता है मेरा बाबा बीमारी से हार जाएगा। कभी कभी लगता है बाबा लौट के घर नहीं आएगा। मेरे बाबा को बचाओ, इस देश को सिर्फ मेरे बाबा से मत चलाओ, क्योंकि देश को देश का हर आदमी चलाता है। क्योंकि देश को देश का हर आदमी चलाता है।
What I meant was, stop being dependent on somebody. क्योंकि इस देश को इस देश का हर आदमी चलाता है। ऑल वी डू इज ब्लेम गेमिंग। ओके, सी व्हेन अ हाउस कैन केटर टू 10 पीपल, इमेजिन इफ 50 ऑफ देम कम। ओके, दैट्स व्हाट हैपन टू आवर हॉस्पिटल्स। एंड what one person can change this country? Yes, one person can definitely change this country, and it's always starts with me. Unfortunately, okay, I don't want to tell any other profession, I want to tell my profession. When the country started manufacturing doctors in the name of paying capacity and religion, okay, can you expect good doctors, committed doctors? It's just a thought for your introspection, that's all. Let us support each other. Okay, when someone needs help, okay, let us just extend how much we can, at least, okay, a psychological, moral support. Okay, so it's not being sympathetic, it's being empathetic. Okay, and today people talk, but we don't want people who can talk, we want leaders. Okay, what your slogan, leaders? We don't want boss, we want leaders. So whenever somebody is in need, okay, you have to just say, okay, I will just pray for you. That will help the person to help himself. That's all you can do. Okay. So giving a fish will solve one time meal, but helping the person to catch a fish, okay, will solve permanently. Please understand this. So it's time. I want to end saying that this is just for a prerogative, like instead of body, people had to develop antibody. Likewise, instead of having social security, everybody thought monetary security was real one. Until unless we work as a team, because I always feel teachers have a huge role in society. If I am like this today, it's because of my parents and by my teachers. Right from my kindergarten to my post-graduation. Okay. All of you can build this nation, wonderful nation. So I want to end with one more clipping, because there is a lot of rot that needs to be cleaned in this country, and it should be taught in the schools. So finally, I want to show this clipping, emphasizing the need to clean the pollution.
साफ करते रहोगे और लोग कचरा करते रहेंगे, अरे कुछ नहीं होगा इस देश का, देखा? हाँ, हो सकता है, बस थोड़ी और सफाई करनी पड़ेगी।
कैसे?
ये आपका खत आया है।
किसका है?
किसी भारत ने भेजा है।
हमारा गांव में तो कोई भारत है नहीं।
मैं किसी भारत को नहीं जानती।
पढ़ लो, शायद कोई पहचान वाला हो। सदर प्रणाम। शायद आप मुझे पहचानते नहीं हो, पर मैं आपको जानता हूं बहुत करीब से। कई बार कई जगहों पर हम मिल भी चुके हैं,
और हर मुलाकात एक याद बनती है। याद है जब वह अमिश्रा की बीवी जब तो इसे कूड़ा फेंक रही थी, तब आप ही ने तो उसे डांटा था।
गांधी चौराहे के सामने वाली दीवार पर जब आदमी थूक रहा था, तब आप ही ने तो उसे रोका था। किसी दूसरे ने फेंका हुआ कचरा जब आपने उठाकर कचरे के डिब्बे में डाला था ना, तब मुझे बड़ा गर्व महसूस हुआ था कि आज का नौजवान भी मेरी इतनी कदर करता है।
आपके बहुत एहसान है मुझ पर, नहीं तो भला कौन सोचता है इन छोटी छोटी बातों के बारे में।
मैं शुक्रगुजार हूँ आपका मेरी इतनी इज्जत करने के लिए। मैं शुक्रगुजार हूँ मेरी तरक्की के खातिर आपके इस छोटे कदम के। मैं शुक्रगुजार हूँ मुझे महान बनाने के लिए आपका प्रिय भारत। सच बात बताओ मोहन दादा, मतलब मुझे नहीं लगता कि इतनी आसानी से।
मुबारक हो मोहन दादा,
अरे अपना देश साफ हो रहा है।
हाँ, पर और एक खत देना बाकी है।
आपको ये आपका खत आया है, किसी भारत ने भेजा है।
Whenever I get goosebumps, how many ever times I see this, because I want to listen to those words, apna desh saaf ho raha hai, ye gandi logon ki saaf karna kab shuru hota hai. Clean your mind, let us clean our mind, let us clean our society, let us have a very pure spirit of beautiful Bharat. And each one of us have this responsibility, this social commitment to make our India proud. Mera Bharat Mahan. Thank you very much. Thank you. I would be very happy to take questions because I have just taken 1 hour for my presentation.
Thank you so much, sir. Your presentation, I think, has put all of us to think and has got tears in our eyes. You started teaching, telling us about happy, how happy hormones can be released. And then the four Ds, Sukha Pranayama. And above all, you just didn't talk to us about keeping ourselves mentally and emotionally fit, but you also gave us lessons for citizenship and lessons of humanity. I think that was the icing on the cake, and you have taught us the right values that Indians always uphold. Sarve janaha sukhino bhavantu. We are indeed honored to be listening to you, and I'm sure you've made an impact on our minds, and we have already started reflecting. Thank you so much for the impactful session, sir. I would now hand over the mic to Ms. Aileen Jethro, who's going to invite questions from our audience and continue the rest of the session. Thank you once again, sir.
Dear audience, I believe that all of you will join me in thanking Sir Dr. Ravish for this wonderful session. I'm sure many minds and hearts are overwhelmed and have queries and questions, things that you would like to ask now. The platform is open. The chat box is enabled. Anyone who would like to ask can raise hands, unmute, or even send their questions on the chat box. We'll be very happy to take them.
So by the time we get the first question, I would like to ask you one question which will help all of us. Sure. The biggest information source for all of us today is the WhatsApp University, which is pumping in a lot of information, which is leaving most of us confused. So can you please tell us how much of it should be trusted and what really has to be our approach towards WhatsApp?
I always have one stand with social media. Just how you say no to drugs, no to social media. Social media is only for connecting and then some kind of entertainment. Otherwise, no scientific information should be passed on in the social media. It's not the right place at all. People think that I am very radical in thinking like that, but that's the only way we can reassure that, you all know recently the WhatsApp, Facebook, Twitter, all having a legal battle with the central government. So we should always go by those media agency, for example, which are authentic and responsible. Okay. So here, nothing is authentic. So please always, if you want to gather information, seek from the authorized sites only.
Thank you, sir.
Anyone else for the questions? Any more queries or questions? It seems like it has been a full package and there are no queries.
No, if someone feels shy, they can just put it in the chat box.
Yes, exactly. Something very rare that has happened this time in this webinar is that people are writing that they were watching it with their families. So usually it is very restricted only to the people, principals and teachers, but this time it has been an overall experience for everyone.
Dr. Ravish, you have created so much of emotion in this last 1 hour that everybody is just sinking in, I think everybody, this 200 odd people and their families, as Alin is saying, I think everybody's overwhelmed, right? And it appears so much real that to control grief and anxiety and depression, you know, apart from a divine mandate, I think a lot lies in our own hands also. And we can manage it, we can help each other, and you have amply demonstrated it. And that is why I think there is no question. I think there's no question to you directly. Everybody is asking question to themselves, how to respond to Dr. Ravish's appeal. Yes. And that is why everybody is just dumb, speechless.
I think there is a question, Mr. Sundaresh, how science is different from technology. Okay, see, now we are all using online platform, okay? That's a technology. But the science is having a controlled screen exposure. Okay, that is science. How much healthy you can watch screens, whether it is computer screens, television screens, your mobile screens, overall in a day. Okay, because when I was doing my post-graduation, okay, more than 60 minutes of exposure was abnormal. But it's been changing. It's been changing depending on the necessity. Okay. So if someone is unable to control his urge to go and check whether the message has come, okay, every now and then, and always contemplating in the mind that, okay, I should send this message, I should send this email, and before going to bed, okay, he has to check his mobile. Such kind of things are the harder part of the technology. But science is how much healthy this technology can be used. We have to get appraised with the newer things. But again, I keep telling you, never forget the basics. Okay. The basics are Panchabhutas, five elements. What I showed you, that bird chirping, okay? Always balance these five elements. So in a day, you can't keep eating at irregular intervals, okay? So you have to stimulate your taste, you have to stimulate your skin, your eyes, okay? So please understand this. That is science. And finally, the spiritual science is, why are you doing all these things? See, Ashokji said that, okay, he made me feel that you're all my family, I can proudly say. I have been educated in Europe, I worked in Europe, worked in Australia, but I never felt I belong there. I came back and I joined government service because even if I do extra bit, it goes to my people. That is the spiritual science, which I think every one of us should inculcate and develop and leave it to the person, to the next generation.
Absolutely, absolutely. As Ashok sir mentioned, I think they are diving deep into their brains now.
Yes. Sir.
Generally, in all the normal webinars, what we see is the PPT is given, something is noted, okay, we'll think, we'll follow it. This is something, an eye-opener for all the leaders of the schools or the teachers. Something which is very specific, grief, stress, and anxiety is a kind of opening ourselves. What is grief? What is stress? And what is anxiety? How it is? It is between us only, but we are not able to identify it. We are not able to connect it. Now you have made us to feel it, touch it, attach it, connect it with everybody. Wonderful session, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. So RP sir, you reminded me of my teacher. Okay, he told me, okay, what life is. L-I-F-E. L means love. Love your parents, love yourself. It's not being selfish, okay? It's being selfless, okay? Love. I means inspire, Okay, your work should definitely inspire somebody, inspire you to become a better you tomorrow. F is faith. We all know that faith can move mountains. Okay, a simple H2O, water, kept in front of the God, okay, becomes prasadam. It doesn't chemically change its composition, but it has got that faith, okay, which becomes a elixir. That is F. E is ethical. Never lose our ethical values. Then you don't have to bow anybody.
Excellent, sir. I think that the last bit was really a punch, and you know, we will really try to add life to
our. I have a request.
Yes, sir.
Sir. Yeah.
Yes, RK, sir. Yeah.
I think we can combinedly request Dr. Ravi sir to be on the board of PSPA to guide us, to support us, to help us in future too. On behalf of PSPA, I sincerely request you, pledge you to be a part of this PSPA association, sir.
For the welfare of RP sir, that is not sufficient, not an adequate request. We have to request Dr. Ravish to be PSPA's chief value officer.
Wonderful.
Chief value officer.
Sir, I am part of the medical education unit in my college. So what I believe when you said value, we call it as vital. Because for a doctor, pulse, breath, heartbeat, BP, they're all vital. VITAL, value integrated teaching and learning.
Oh, wonderful.
Okay,
wonderful.
So this vital is essential for teachers, just how it is important for a doctor. So I feel you're all doctors for the nation. You need to, if you are empowered, I think our coming generations will be definitely much better. Because I always remember my high school teacher, he's a drawing teacher. He would say, the Japanese, okay, during the World War, they were really quite aggressive kind of people. But today they are most well-behaved because their education inculcated such things. Okay, that aggression is not seen. Japanese are one of the nicest people. Okay, and luckily India always had a good relation with them. So only by educating. When I say education, it's not just getting information. It's the transformation of personality. That is education. Okay.
Absolutely. So, Dr. Saab, Mysore mein rehte hain, aap thoda Urdu to samajh lenge.
Yes, sir.
Humne jo proposal kiya hai, wo kabool hai ki nahi? Good. Thank you.
Sir, it's a honor. Okay. I told you, I'm part of your family. So,
thank you.
I always feel how much I can benefit to the society, to my nation. That much I feel privileged.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, Dr. Ravish. For accepting. Yeah. Thank you.
I think on this occasion, we must definitely salute your parents and your teacher for creating a wonderful person in you. And I'm sure we'll all have some role model to emulate in you, sir.
Thank our community so only, madam. Our community.
Yes, sir. We feel proud. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Eileen, ma'am, I think if there are no questions, I mean, we can propose the vote of thanks.
Yeah, we can proceed.
Yeah. Can we, if some people who are comfortable, if they can enable their videos, can we have a group photograph?
Yes.
So... yeah, thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. All those who are comfortable can just enable. Fine. I'm going to take the screenshot now. Can I also request everyone to smile?
Yeah. We are all smiling inside.
Thank you so much, Dan. So, in Hindi, there is also a saying, Gagar mein Sagar. This has couldn't be truer than the last 1 hour that we have experienced. In this small 1 hour, it was like a life experience. Things that all of us experienced internally, everyone, whether it has been a personal loss in our families or in our friend circle or not, has been actually empathizing with the world, with our countrymen, in India in particular right now. It was so sad when on Facebook we were seeing our friends abroad saying that they're back to hugging each other for meetings they were getting together. And in India, it is only getting worse. So now today, after having heard Dr. Ravish, it was such an eye-opener as to what I can do. I myself, and all of us felt the same way. So we can't thank you enough for this past 1 hour that you have devoted for all of us who are present here. There is a Swedish proverb that says, those who wish to sing always find a song. Such is life. And more so in these pandemic times. PSPA, all my friends here, extend heartfelt gratitude to you, sir, for escorting us through this difficult path of handling grief, anxiety, and stress, for encouraging us to find our song. We are truly grateful to you, sir. Thank you so very much.
Thank you very much.
A big thank you to our honorary president, Mr. Ashok Pandey, a person who's been the wind beneath PSPA, a supporter and encourager relentlessly, and always there to guide us and make such wonderful sessions possible. Thank you, Ashok sir, so much. Without the determined perseverance of our president, Mr. Rajendra Prasad, none of this could have been possible. We couldn't have achieved any of this. Our gratitude to you, RP sir. The cogwheels of a system run only through teamwork. My gratitude to the whole executive committee and members of PSPA and the technical team for making such meaningful initiatives possible. On behalf of PSPA, warm and hearty gratitude to all the participants, the delegates, for their time, for their perseverance, for their encouragement and support, not just today, but in all our endeavors. Thank you, dear delegates. Thank you so much. And finally, from beginning to this very moment, I thank the Almighty for His providence, for His protection and His peace. Thank you all. God bless you all till we meet again. Rab Rakha.
Yeah. Eileen, ma'am.
Thank you, Ravish, sir. Thank you so much.
Hello, Eileen, ma'am.
Yes, Ashok, sir.
You see, Guru Govind do khade, to Govind ji, yes. Dr. Ravish ko le kaun aya?
Savita, madam, thank
Savita
you.
Savita ko bhi dhanyabad dijiye.
Ji, 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 ji.
Nahin to Dr. Savita nahin hoti, to hum Govind se mil nahin paate.
Bilkul, wo to meri team mein hai, sir. Thank you so much, Savita, ma'am. Aapke bina, ye to possible. Thank you so much.
Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, thank you.